Ladies and gentlemen, probably about 2 years ago, I did a video talking about the baby industry, baby diapers, baby toys, baby furniture, baby clothes were all losing money because of the low birth rate. And I said even back then it was going to have a domino effect. And it is. And let me start by saying locally, I am starting to see the daycares close. There was one on the corner from where I stay, and that daycare center has been there for years. In fact, when I was a teenager, that daycare center was there, and it was there all the way up until this past winter. And then there was a sign there saying daycare moving. And I'm like, why? Why are they just uprooting and leaving? There's no hardly no kids. There's hardly no kids there. So they closed down shop here and they had a second location that had more children. So the few children that they had at this daycare, they just moved them over to another daycare. But that was why it was the lack of children. Not that many small kids anymore. So if it's going to affect all of those other industries, you can definitely expect it to impact child care services. It's unavoidable. So this came out, ladies and gentlemen, from Central Illinois. And it's July 2nd, 2019. Local child care program stops services. Poor economic climate is forcing Neighborhood House to stop offering child care services as of next month. After providing child care to local children for 115 years. Wow. CEO Becky Rossman said low birth rate and fierce competition led to the decision to close on August 9th. 115 years of providing care to children. And it all has to end because of low birth rate. Ladies and gentlemen, in my opinion, when this next recession hit, a lot of daycare services are going to close their doors. This is just my prediction. All right. So Neighborhood House was very progressive when they started offering childcare services in 1904, she said. But the dynamics have changed and the need is not as relevant today. Since funding is tied to enrollment, Rossman said the upcoming increase in minimum wage was also a determining factor to stop services. This was a very difficult decision with a projected deficit of $100,000 to serve 30 children. It was the right thing to do to ensure Neighborhood House continues to be strong now and well into the future, she said. Neighborhood House has survived 123 years by evolving to meet the most relevant needs of the community and will continue to do so. Neighborhood House is one of seven licensed centers in the 61605 zip code. This is one of many. This is one of many. There was a daycare that I sent my son to only in the summer. And it's because at this particular daycare, ladies and gentlemen, they offered summer camp. And I didn't want him really out in the streets all the time. So I allowed my son to be enrolled in this day camp. And it was really nice. It was ran by a black man, he and his wife ran a year-round daycare center, but in the summer they had day camp. And they would take the children on a field trip every single day. Every day. The only time they wouldn't go if it was an outdoor activity somewhere and it rained. Then they just gave the kids activities to do at the facility. But my son had a blast. They went down to the shore and went whale watching. They went on a lot of educational trips. They went to like the Franklin Institute and the art museum over in Philadelphia. So they just went around to all of these different places doing, you know, activity. And I liked it because it was a lot of learning activity and they would go fishing. And so it was a lot of things they did to keep the children busy. And I didn't mind. And he loved it. You know, he loved being around the other kids and they were traveling. And this man had a full-size van that he would take the kids in. And they called him, his name was Philip, but the kids used to call him Mr. Phil. And they ran the daycare around here for years. We went driving past where the facility is. It is gone. The building is literally sitting there empty. So I've seen quite a few of the daycares even around me disappear. They're not there anymore. So this is the signs of the time and the signs that the birth rate being low is real, y'all. That is a real thing. But please tell me what you think, ladies and gentlemen. Please leave your comment and subscribe. Don't forget to hit on the notification bell, and I'll see you on the next video. Peace, family.